Hello friends, this is Dr. Nikisha Jariwala. Welcome to the tutorial of ASP.NET. This is the second part of the tutorial of online shopping system. Within the first part of the tutorial, we have already learned about designing the page, displaying products within the data list control along with the images, and also we have seen how we can increment and decrement the quantity for the particular product which we want to order from the website. So this is the second part of the tutorial, and within this we will see the functionality of add to cart. And for all the functionality, we have already placed button controls within the data list control. Before continuing with the tutorial, there is an important note which I have already specified in the first part also, that as the tutorial is too long, I have divided the tutorial into more than one videos, and the links of all the videos are specified within the description box. So it will be easier for you to navigate from one part to the another part. So now let's continue with our tutorial. Before moving ahead towards the implementation, first of all, let's know the concept of the cart. We can say that cart is a container which will hold the products that we want to purchase from the website. So we can say it is a temporary container, because as soon as we order the product, the cart will get empty. So for that purpose, I have created one table, that is TBL cart. And this table is a temporary table, because as soon as we will order the products, we will delete the records from this table. Let's see the fields within this table. First is the username, as we want to specify that which user has added the product within the cart. So for that purpose, username, then obviously product ID and product name, that is the details related to the product. Quantity, that is the total number of quantity which we want to order for that particular product. Its price, total amount, that is quantity multiplied by price. Image path for this particular product, and the cart ID. Over here, cart ID is set to the primary key, and along with that, it is also set as an auto increment with the help of identity specification property, which I have set it to yes. So now let's design the page, and for that purpose, I will add another view within the multi-view control. So for that purpose, view control. So view 2, that is the second view, is added within the multi-view control. What is the logic? As soon as the user click on this add to cart button within the data list control, the record will be added within TBL cart table. And to display the cart, we will provide one link to the user. So first of all, let's add the link. So I will add link button control. So here it is. Let's change its property. Let's set ID property to LBTN. Cart. I will set text property to my cart, and on the click event of this link button, I will open view 2, within which I will display the products which the user has added within the cart. So for that purpose, I will write multiview 1 dot active view index is equal to 1, that is the index of the second view. Now let's design the view for cart. So for that purpose, we will add grid view control from the data tab. So here is the control. Let's change its ID property to GV cart, that is grid view cart. And from the smart tag of the control, let's set the data source. We will select new data source, select SQL database. Then we will select the connection string. We will select TBL cart table from the list of the table. We will specify the where condition, because we want to display the records for the username which we have stored within the session. So from the column field, we will select username. Operator we will select as equal to. Source we will select as session, as we will get the value from the session. Session field, which we have already specified in the previous video, is uname. So we will specify that, then we will click on add button, so the where condition is formed, and then we will click on OK. Along with that, we will also generate insert, update, delete statements automatically. So for that purpose, we have clicked on advanced, and we have checked the checkbox property. Let's test the query. Username, we know it is Nikisha Jariwala. Obviously, right now there are no products for Nikisha Jariwala within the cart, so the cart will be empty. And then we will click on finish. So this is the default layout of our cart. Now let's make some changes within the cart. So let's move on to the source. Let's make some changes. We will set visible property for the username to false, as we don't want to display username within the cart. We will also set visible property of image path to false, as we don't want to display image path field within the cart. So we will set it to false, and we will also set visible property of cart ID to false. So let's see the design. So we are able to see product ID, product name, quantity, price and total. Now as we want to display image, we will add one field, or we can say one column, within the grid view control. And for that purpose, from the smart tag we will select add new column. Then we will select the template field. Let's give the header text as a photograph. Click on OK. So one column is added within the grid view control and it is of template field. Let's move it to the source. So here it is. Now within this template field we will add item template, and within this item template, as we want to display image, so we will add image control. Now within this image control, let's set image URL property, and image URL property will come from the image path field which is present within the grid view control. So for that purpose we will specify image URL equal to single quotation angle bracket percentage, so the percentage angle bracket will appear by default. Then we will write hash eval, which is the function that will fetch the value for the field from the table, and within that we will pass the name of the field, that is image path. Height is equal to 50 and width is equal to 50 as well. Let's save the page. So our grid view will look like this. Now cart is the container for the product from which we can remove the products as well as add new products within the cart. So to add the product within the cart, we have already provided the functionality within the data list control. But if we want to remove the products from the cart, then for that purpose we can set enable deleting functionality within the cart. So the delete link will appear within the grid view control. Now let's move on to source. Let's see, here is the delete query, that is delete from TBL cart where cart ID is equal to @ and the original value, and we need to remove the remaining fields from the delete query because cart ID is the primary key, and with the help of cart ID the record can be deleted from the table. So we have removed remaining fields. Let's save the page. Let's move on to design. So here is the cart. Along with the cart, we also need to display the total amount that the user have to pay if the user orders all the products which is present within the cart from the website. So for that purpose, we will add one label control. So let's place one label control. Here it is. Let's change its ID property to LBL. Total, and I will remove the text property of the label, and after that we will provide the checkout button. So by clicking on the checkout button, user will able to order each and every products that are present within the cart. So let's place one button control. Here it is. Let's set its property. I will set the ID property of the button control as BTN checkout and text property of the button control as checkout. Before moving towards the coding, let's see what are the functionalities which we need to implement. First of all, whenever user click on this add to cart button, the product must be added within the cart table, that is over here, which we have already created. After that, if user wants to see all the products that the user has added within the cart, then by clicking on this link button, user would be able to see that. So for that purpose, by clicking on this link button, the view, we need to change it to view 2, and the products will be displayed within this grid view control. Another important thing which we need to display is the total amount which the user needs to pay if the user orders all the products within the cart. We also need to provide delete functionality within the cart. So for that purpose, I have added this delete link. If the user delete products from the cart, then the total amount should also be changed. And after that, by clicking on this checkout button, the user must be able to order all the products which are present within the cart. So for that purpose, we will need two tables, that is TBL orders and TBL order details. So first of all, let's see the fields within these two tables. TBL orders table contains four fields, that is order ID, which is the primary key and it is of integer data type, order date of date data type, that is on the date on which the user has ordered the product. Third field is order status. Order of the status can be one of the values, that is it can be confirmed, it can be dispatched, it can be shipped. So for that purpose, we have taken varchar 50 data type. Last field is the username, that is the user who has placed the order. Second table is order details. So let's see, order details contains three fields, that is order ID, which is the foreign key, which we have already created within the TBL orders table. So TBL orders will be the parent table and TBL order details will be the child table. So order ID, that is of integer data type, PID, that is the product ID, and quantity, that is the number of quantity that the user wants to order for this particular product. So this is all about TBL order details table. So now let's move towards the implementation. I have already added the code so that the time is not wasted while typing. For that purpose, I have already added the code for all the functionalities which we have discussed right now. So here is the code. Within the first part of the video, we have already seen plus and minus functionality, which we have implemented with the help of command name property of e argument of the event. So we will use the same thing. So again, I have specified if condition over here, that is e command name is equal to add to cart. Add to cart is the command name property which we have already specified for this add to cart button. So if the user click on add to cart button, then first of all, I want to gather the quantity which the user has changed for that particular product. So for that purpose, again, it is the same logic, that is e, that is the argument, dot item, that is the row which the user has selected. Within that, we will find the control and the name of the label for the quantity is LBL quantity. So the reference of this is added within LBL, which is the instance of label class. After that, we will check that if the quantity is zero or not. If it is zero, then we will display a message to the user that please add the quantity. If the quantity is not zero, then obviously we will insert the record within the cart table. So for that purpose, first of all, I have created object of SQL command class, that is CMD. Within that, I have specified the insert query, that is insert into TBL cart values, and I have specified parameters for all the fields which we have created within the cart table. And after that, as a second parameter, we will pass the object of the connection class, that is CON. Now let's add one by one all the parameters within the parameters collection of command object. So cmd.parameters.add, first parameter is username, and the username will come from the session which we have already added on the login page. Then we need to add product ID, and we will find product ID from the data list control, that is with the help of e argument. Again the same thing, item property, and within that find control method, we will find the label with the name product ID label, which is present in the design view. It's over here. As the name of the label control within which the product ID is displayed is product ID label. So the control will be found out, and the reference of that label control will be assigned to LBL PID, which is the instance of label class. And the value of that LBL PID is assigned to the PID parameter of the query. And as it is a text, that is a string value. So with the help of CINT function, the value is converted into integer, as PID is of integer data type. After that, we will add the product name. The name of the label control of the product name is product name label within the data list. So we have specified that control name over here. The reference will be assigned to LBLP name, and that LBLP name is used to assign value to @PNM parameter, which is of varchar data type. After that, we have already assigned the quantity within LBL label. So that I have directly used over here, that is LBL.text. And with the help of CINT function, I have converted that value within integer, as the data type of the quantity parameter is integer. After that, we need to gather the value of the price label. It's the name of the price label is price label. So that is specified over here. The reference of this label is assigned to LBL price, and this LBL price instance is used to assign value to @price parameter of our query. And with the help of CINT function, obviously it will be converted into the integer data type, as the data type of the price parameter is int. And by then we need to calculate the total. So with the help of quantity and price, we have done multiplication of that both the field, and it is assigned to @total parameter, which is of integer data type. And by the end, we also need image path for our image, and it is present within image path label. It is over here. So we have specified that name over here. We will find that label control, and the reference of that label control is assigned to LBLIMG, and that label is used to assign value to @img parameter of the query, which is of varchar data type. After specifying all the parameters for the query within the parameters collection, we will open the connection. We will execute the query with the help of execute non-query method of CMD, and then we will close the connection. After that, we will also set the visible property of BTN checkout button to true, because as we don't want to display checkout button if the cart is empty. But now there will be at least one product within the cart, so we have set visible property to true. And after that, we have displayed the message to the user that the product is added within the cart, and if the user wants to view the cart, then user can click on my cart link. So that message will be displayed, and then the quantity will be set to 0. Now let's see the coding of my cart link button. I have already written the coding, so let's see. First of all, obviously, by clicking on the link button, we will move to the second view, and the index property of the second view will be set to 1. After that, we need to bind data to our grid view control. That is the grid view control which is present within the view 2. So as we want to bind the data, so over here I have used gvcart, which is the name of our grid view control, and then I have used data bind method through which the data will be bind with the control. Then within the try catch block, as I want to display the total amount after the cart, I have added that logic. So within the try block, first of all, I have created object of SQL command class, that is CMD. Within that, I have specified the query, that is select sum of total from TBL cart, where username is equal to @uname. That is, the summation of all the values of the total field will be calculated with the help of this query, and it will be written from the query. But over here, the records of those users will be used for which the username will be retrieved from the session. So over here we have added the parameters within the parameters collection, that is @uname. It is of varchar data type, and the value will come from the session. After that, we need to execute the query, but the query will return a singleton value. Now the thing is that if no product is present within the cart for this particular user, then it will return the null value. So for that purpose, first of all, we will check whether the value written by the query is null or not. So for that purpose, we have opened the connection, After that, within the if condition, we have checked cmd.execute scalar. Value is null or not. And if we want to check the value that is null or not, we need to use system.dbNull.value. So that condition is specified over here. If the value is null, so obviously the total will also be zero. But instead of displaying the zero amount, we will display your cart is empty, continue shopping. And that will be displayed as bold. So for that purpose, I have used B tag within this label control. And again, after that, we will set visible property of checkout button to false, because as there are no products present within the cart, so checkout button will not appear on the page. But if the query returns the value, that is the query returns the total amount, then within the else condition, we will specify total amount to be paid and the value will come from the cmd.executeScalar method. And this whole thing is assigned in LBL total label. And after that, obviously we will set visible property of BTN checkout to true, because now the products are present within the cart. And then after the if condition, we will close the connection. Now this is the catch block, which we have already seen in the previous part. So we will not concentrate on that. Let's move further. So the implementation which we have completed is the records from the cart table, which will be displayed within the grid view control. Along with that, it will also display the total amount which the user needs to pay. And we have also set visible property to true of this checkout button. The logic behind the checkout button. Now, when the user clicks on the checkout button, first of all, the record will be added in TBL orders table. After that, we will retrieve all the records from the cart with the help of select query. And then, one by one, each and every record will be inserted in TBL order details table. After inserting the records within TBL order details table, we will also update the quantity within TBL products table. Because obviously, as the products are ordered, so quantity will be decreased within the table. After that, after adding all the records, we will delete the records for that particular user from the cart table. So the cart will get empty for the user. So let's see the implementation. So here it is, BTN checkout click event. Now before inserting records within TBL orders table, I want to generate order ID, because within TBL orders table, I have not set order ID to auto increment. That I will do by my own. So for that purpose, first of all, I have created one subroutine, that is generate order ID. Let's go to its definition. So this is the definition of generate order ID subroutine. Within this generate order ID subroutine, first of all, we will create object of SQL command class, that is CMD. Within that, we will specify the query, that is select max of order ID from TBL orders, that is the last order that is inserted within TBL orders table. Its ID will be written, and along with that, we have also passed the connection object within the CMD object. After that, we will open the connection, execute the query with the help of execute scalar method, as the query will return a singleton value, and the value will be assigned to OID, which is the variable that we have created over here, and it is of integer data type. And then we will close the connection. Now there is a condition when no orders are present within the orders table. So at that time, it will return the null value. So obviously, this statement will generate the exception. So it will move on to the catch block. And within catch block, we have assigned order ID to 1. Now, if the order ID is not null, means there are some orders present within TBL orders table. So for that purpose, over here we have checked the condition that if OID is not equal to 0, then we will increment the value which is present within the OID variable. So this is the logic through which we will able to generate order ID. Now again, let's move on to the checkout button. So this is the click event of the checkout button, and within that, first of all, we have called that our subroutine, that is generate order ID, through which the order ID will be generated. After that, we will insert the records within TBL orders table. So for that purpose, again, we have created object of SQL command class, that is CMD. We have specified the insert query, that is insert into TBL orders. We have specified the fields, that is OID, ODate, that is order date, order status and username. And after that, values, and then we have specified the parameters, that is at the rate OID, at the rate OD, at the rate OS, and at the rate UNM. Now let's add all the parameters within the parameters collection of CMD. So these are the statements for that. At the rate OID is of integer data type, and the value will come from OID variable, where OID is assigned with the help of this generate order ID subroutine. At the rate ODate will contain the value of order date, so it will be of date data type, and the value will come from date time class, and within that now property. At the rate OS, that is order status, it is of varchar data type, and by default I have specified the value confirmed. And at the rate UNM variable is of varchar data type, and the value will come from the session. Now for executing the query, we will open the connection, we will execute the query with the help of execute non-query method of CMD, that is the command, and then we will close the connection. Now let's move further. Now the second thing which we need to do on the checkout button is, we need to retrieve all the records that are present within TBL cart table. As we are using the same object name, so first of all we will set that object to nothing, so the reference will be removed. After that, again with the help of new keyword, we will create the object, and we have specified the query, that is select product ID and quantity from TBL cart, where username is equal to at the rate uname. Again the same thing, uname, that is at the rate UNM parameter, will be assigned a value from the session. Here the records which are retrieved from TBL cart will be stored within the data set. So for that purpose, first of all, we have created object of SQL data adapter, that is DA, and within that SQL data adapter constructor, we have passed CMD object. After that, we will create the object of dataset class. Then with the help of data adapter, that is DA, we will fill the dataset, that is DS, and the table within the dataset is named as C. Now, as there can be more than one records within the table, so we have iterated for loop, that is for I as integer, and obviously the index of the record will be records will be starts with 0. So the for loop is iterated from 0 to the rows count minus 1, that is DS, that is the data set, within that C is the table, rows is the collection of the rows, count is the property which will return the count of total number of rows present within the C table, and we have used minus 1 because the index starts with 0. After that, again we have created object of command class. Within that we have specified the insert query to insert records within TBL order details table. So for that purpose, insert into TBL order details values, and there were three parameters. We have added three parameters within the query, that is order ID, product ID and quantity. The value of order ID will come from OID variable. The value of PID parameter will come from the row which is present within the data set. So for that purpose, we have written DS, that is the data set. Within that C is the table. We will access the collection, that is rows, and I is the variable which we have iterated within the for loop. And from that row, we will retrieve item at 0 index. So at 0 index, the column will be product ID. So that is retrieved. The value is converted into integer with the help of CINT method, and it is assigned to at the rate PID parameter. After that, we need to assign value to at the rate QTY parameter. So again the same procedure, the value will come from the dataset, that is vs.tables, that is C is the table. From that we will access the rows collection, and from that rows collection we will access the value which is present at column number 1, that is quantity. So it is assigned to at the rate QTY parameter. After that, to execute the query, we will open the connection, we will execute the query, and then we will close the connection. Now we need to update TBL products table. So again, we have created object of command class, that is CMD. Then we have specified the update query, that is update TBL products. We need to set quantity is equal to quantity minus at the rate QTY, that is the quantity which is specified by the user. And for the product ID, that is obviously we will specify the condition, that is where product ID is equal to at the rate PID. So at the rate PID value will again from, so at the rate PID value will again come from this product ID, and quantity value will come from this quantity field of TBL card table. So for that purpose, again we have written the same statements which we have already written over here. And after that, we will open the connection, we will execute the query, and then we will close the connection. So this whole procedure is done for all the records that are present within TBL card table. After that, as the order is placed successfully, so we will display message to the user, that is orders placed successfully. And then, as we have discussed, we need to remove all the records from the card table. So for that purpose, again I have created object of SQL command class, that is CMD. Within that I have written the delete query, that is delete from TBL card, where username is equal to at the rate uname. And again, the value for at the rate uname parameter will come from the session. Again the same procedure, we will open the connection, we will execute the query, and then we will close the connection. And after that, we have set the active view index property of multi view control to 0. So again, the view will change to view 1. So the list of products will be displayed. Moving further, let's see the delete functionality within this cart. So for that purpose, we have already specified the link of the delete. So the delete query will be fired from here, as the query is specified over here, which we have already seen. But along with that, we also need to change the value of the amount that the user need to pay when the user will order the products. So for that purpose, I have used row deleted event of the cart, that is row deleted event of the grid view control. This event will be executed after the row is deleted from the grid view control. So within try block, again I have created object of command class, that is CMD. Within that I have specified the query to calculate the total, that is select sum of total from TBL cart, where username is equal to at the rate uname. Again the value for at the rate uname will come from the session. After that we need to execute the query, so we will open the connection. Now this if condition we have already seen. So it is same which we have specified on my cart link button. So it is totally same which I have written over here. That is, if the value is null for execute scalar method, then we will display that your cart is empty. We need to continue the shopping, and we will set visible property of the checkout button to false. But if the value is not null, then obviously we will display the total amount that is to be paid by the user, and after that we will close the connection. Over here we have completed the implementation of add to cart functionality, and along with that we have also placed the order. Now let's move on to the design. Now within design we will add another link button to display the products. So let's add one link button. Let's change its property. Let's change its ID property to LBTN product and text property to products. So what we want to do, by clicking on this link button, view 1 will be displayed. That is, the list of products will be displayed. Let's write its code. That is LTView1.ActiveViewIndex is equal to 0. Here the index of view 1 is 0. So we have said multiview1.ActiveViewIndex is equal to 0. Execute the application. So here is our login page. Let's log in into our website by specifying username and password. This is the list of our products. Let's add some products within the cart. Let's add 2 quantities of sketch pen within the cart. So the message is displayed that is product is added in the cart. Click on my cart to view it. But we want to add another products also. So I will add 1 quantity of the book within the cart and 3 quantities of pen within the cart. So I want to buy these 3 products. Now let's see my cart. So these are the 3 products which I have added within the cart. So here total is displayed and over here total amount is displayed which I need to pay if I buy all the products which are present within the cart. But as my mind has changed, I don't want to buy, let's say, book. So I will delete book from the cart. So let's see. Obviously the amount is changed. Before, previously it was 435, now it has changed to 400, that is 300 plus 100. So I want to buy sketch pen and pen. So now let's click on checkout. Here the message is displayed, that is orders placed successfully. So now if we will view, our cart is empty as we have ordered all the products which were present within the cart. So the message is displayed, your cart is empty, continue shopping. And obviously the checkout button is also not visible on the page. Let's see the products. So by clicking on the products link, we are able to navigate to view 1, that is the list of our products. So this is the end of part 2 of our tutorial. Within the third part of the tutorial, we will see the functionalities related to add to wishlist, and we will also display the orders which the customer has placed. If the tutorial is helpful to you, please like and share the video. Also subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss the update. Thank you.